Get ready to lose.
What we think we will find in Area 51. What we will actually find in Area 51. PS1 Hagrid. My pet alien from Area 51 going sicko mode after feeding it too many Flintstone vitamins.
Oh my god.
Be honest, did you laugh? No? Okay, cool. Hi, my name is Destry. I laugh at really stupid shit. How's it going? So here's how this works, okay? You have three lives. You laugh once, you lose a life. You laugh twice, uh-oh. You laugh three times, and you have to buy my merch. I don't make the rules, that's just how it is. That means me too. I have to buy my own merch.
Oh no, dude!
Who wears their own merch? You know? Anyways, yes, welcome back, guys, to another Don't Laugh Challenge brought to you by back pain. Have you ever tried a trampoline trick and landed incorrectly, thus causing a tremendous amount of pain and making every waking moment pure agony? Then back pain is for you! Before we get into the videos, guys, I'd like to give a thanks to the sponsor of this video, Raid Shadow Legends. So Raid Shadow Legends is a fantastically reviewed smartphone RPG with completely immersive gameplay and storyline that honestly is just super crazy that it's on a mobile platform. Like, there are plenty of games that exist on console and computer that look worse than this game, which blows my mind. Anyways, Raid is super awesome because not only do you have like the traditional RPG elements, like crazy storyline, really great voice acting, giant boss fights, but you also have the PvP side of things where you could take on massive amounts of enemies and just frick up a bunch of people. And probably the coolest part is that you can actually collect a bunch of different heroes, so you're not always playing as the same person as you're going through the game. So me, for example, I started the game and I just decided to be this weird dark elf guy. There's an orc guy with his nipples out. It's insane. Just check out the detail of this guy's nipples. Whoa! Getting back on topic, sorry. And with over 200,000 reviews, all of which are almost perfect scores, the game is deservingly growing fast, so definitely check it out. Go down in the description, click my special link to get 50,000 silver and a free epic hero to start you out on your journey. All right, now let's get into these videos. I really need something to pick me up. I've been sad and single way too long. Now, I don't think that these videos are gonna help out with me being single, but I definitely think they'll help me being sad. So let's f-ing jump into the first one. Damn it! Come on! I f***ing laughed. Son of a bitch.
Son of a bitch.
It's always the ones that you don't expect. Like, you don't expect Uncle Ben being punched in the face. Being shot several times as he's been rebooted multiple times throughout the MCU, yes. But being punched, no. This reminds me that a while ago, I said that I know I wanted one of my tattoos in the future to just have Uncle Ben's face, and then below it just says, "With great power comes great responsibility." I just want someone to see it and be like, "Destry, why the f*** could you have that as a tattoo?" Uncle Ben really speaks to me, okay? Which is why it upsets me that he's being punched in the face right here. The thing I love about the MCU Spider-Man and Tom Holland is that we didn't have to f***ing see Uncle Ben die again. He came pre-murdered, which is really great. What the hell would cause a dog to make this sound? Like, what the f***? What was that other video that we watched a while ago? It was like Mr. Bubs or something?
I think he loves me.
I got this on camera.
Okay, while I didn't laugh at this one, I appreciate it. And I also am more questioning what the f*** this person is doing with like an actual liter of margarine on their table. This clearly is a video that originated in Kentucky.
Kentucky, we may have slow internet and slow brains here, but we are number one in chicken and incest.
Mr. Dr. Phil, bring it. Tell me what I f*** on.
All you gotta do is open the door of the car on the freeway and try to throw yourself out into traffic. You want a piece of me, bitch? Come on, bitch.
That's not real. Is this real?
Why don't you shut up, you bald-headed hillbilly? You are one sick son of a bitch.
Are you kidding me?
Ooh. You're disgusting. I'm gonna kill you. Give me $200.
Okay, I think this is definitely fake, but that's still pretty funny. I can't even make any f***ing jokes right now because Dr. Phil is too savage. I'm afraid that if I do make a joke, he'll just come out of the woodworks and f***ing assault me verbally.
Now listen here, Destry. It's 2019, get with the program, cut your goddamn hair, and stop wearing your own merch, you piece of turd.
I'm Chris Hansen with Dateline NBC. Why don't you have a seat right over there?
While I didn't laugh at this one, I do appreciate it because Chris Hansen is an OG. Now, this might be a little bit too old for you guys, but one of my favorite pastimes is watching To Catch a Predator. I don't know why it's so funny to watch predators be uncomfortable for 5 minutes straight, but man, is that entertainment. Holy crap. You guys remember from like Q&A 27 or something, like way back in the day when I made fun of that one guy? This guy.
Are you the only child?
Yeah. Oh, did you bring protection?
Yeah. Yeah.
I still love that clip so much.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now that is entertainment. My God.
Yeah.
I almost said that I missed To Catch a Predator, but in a weird way that makes it seem like I miss when predators were around more. That's not what I meant. There's nothing in the world that makes me smile more than hearing these simple words.
Why don't you have a seat right there?
The only bad news about that is you're probably not going to need that type of protection tonight.
Was already dead when the truck hit her. We have new information now also on the plane crash. KTVU has just learned the names of the four pilots who were on board the flight. They are Captain Sung Ting Wong, Wee Tu Lo, Ho Lee Fook, and Bang Ding Ao. And the NTSB has confirmed these are the names of the pilots on board.
What's kidding me about this clip is that the lady is so serious. Like, she doesn't even realize that this is a joke.
Wee Tu Lo, Ho Lee Fook, and Bang Ding Ao.
Man, I wouldn't have been able to hold it together. Holy shit. Oh man, he didn't like it. This seems like something that I would do. I would risk my life to put glasses on a crocodile. I don't get why this crocodile's so upset about it, man. Don't you know what fashion is? Put those back on.
Check me out. Kim Kardashian's jealous of my big ass. Nicki Minaj has got f*** all on my big badonky donk.
Right, lassies, there's a taxi outside. Grab that bowl of Lamborghini, let's get the f*** out of here.
Aye, you bunch of n***s. Don't you leave without me. I just bought this dress out of Lidl and I look great. Oh, and look, the thieving bastard's wearing my leopard print stilettos that I get off the dodgy cunt down the market. Thieving bastard.
What the hell did that even say?
Oh, and look, the thieving bastard's wearing my leopard print stilettos that I get off the dodgy cunt down the market.
What
bastard.
Is that saying?
Oh, and by the way, Cinderella, I took a right big shite in that toilet upstairs and I can't get it to flush. So, when I get back, that better be gone. Catch you midden.
Why does every Scottish person take the largest shits, apparently?
Well, it was one of yous! Disgusting!
Those three bastards are not going to stop me figuring out the night and patting my f***ing ass off. I'm going to get myself a man the night and going to get shagged rotten.
Holy f***, mate. I'm going to get shagged rotten? What does that mean? That sounds disgusting, dude. I'm going to start saying that from now on. I'm like, yo, I have a girl coming over. I'm going to get shagged rotten. Friends are like, what? What does that mean, dude?
A princess does not place her weapons on the team.
But mom, it's just my...
Did you put your name into the Goblet of Fire, Harry? Dumbledore asked calmly.
Harry! I protest!
Harry, did you put your name in the Goblet of Fire?
Dude, I just watched that movie actually too. But yeah, I do love that in the books it's like, he asked calmly. And then in the movie it's like,
Harry, did you put your name in the Goblet of Fire?
But then again, that is coming from one of the worst Harry Potter movies. There, I said it. Listen, you can argue all you want saying, oh, Goblet of Fire is so good, Destry. What are you talking about? Yeah? Oh, is it? So you're saying that this song that they played at the Yule Ball was just totally an awesome scene?
I learned it to rock and roll. Spin around like a crazy elf.
God, do not even get me started on Harry Potter. I could make an entire video talking about how much I absolutely hate that movie. God damn it, it sucks goblin foreskin, dude. Don't you reply in the comment. I don't want to hear it. Ooh, yes. Another prequel meme, baby.
It's over, Anakin!
I have the high ground!
You underestimate my power!
Don't try it! I definitely don't know this whole movie. this a Skyrim meme? Really? True, though. Wait. Don't end the video there. We have about 5 more minutes of loading time before it gets back there. What's that? Skyrim? More like loading screen the game, am I right? Apple bottom jeans, boots with the fur. The whole club is looking at her. Yes, dude, more prequel memes. Boom!
I have brought peace, freedom, justice, and security to my new empire.
Your new
empire.
Hey, there goes all my ad revenue. Yay! Unless, Destry, were you smart enough to jumble it and make it sound not like a song? Good job, man.
We just beat the YouTube algorithm.
For the past 20 years, Tim's life has been consumed by Pac-Man.
If you've never played Pac-Man before, it's a little something like this.
Look what you've done.
Kim Christ, Tim's wife? What? That guy is married and I'm not? I'll be right back. I am going to go jump off of a building.
Here I go.
5 minutes later.
I'm back. My bones are all mangled. Sorry. Well, that didn't make me want to die at all. It's fine. Auto-tuned cats. This should be great. Boy, with that level of auto-tune, this might as well be Sailing Home, am I right, guys? Hey, I'm allowed to meme on my own album, okay? Plus, I'll have you know, there's not that much auto-tune. It's only in every song, I promise.
Hoo-wee, that Jimmy Neutron kid. Isn't he just a child? My name's Chris Hansen, Dateline NBC. Go ahead and have a seat.
Damn. Yes, I love that the Chris Hansen memes are coming back. I love it. My name is Chris Hansen with Dateline NBC, and you're watching the Disney Channel. These submissions suck. Read it and we app, guys. Four lives left. Shut the f- I get an extra life because I have a receding hairline. Do you? No. So you be happy with your 3 lives.
I did my stunts because I thought that's what everyone did. And then
Tom Cruise over here?
No, I'll be the first me, not the next Tom Cruise. Thank you very much.
Oh man. I don't want to say anything against Brie Larson because she'll think it's a personal attack against her.
Is that like a personal attack or something?
No, it's not. I swear to God. Well, guys, I am happy to admit that I think we made it through this video and I still have this amount of lives left. Wow. I don't have to buy my merch, but you do. But seriously though, if you want to check out my merch, you can check it out at deskmerch.com. I've got some new posters in there that you can have my big creepy face on your wall. But as always, guys, if you'd like to leave a submission to my next Don't Laugh Challenge, you can do that on my Twitter, my Reddit, or my Discord. Links in the description down below. Please do not feel bad if you want to send me like just 100 different videos, mainly so I could have my unpaid intern go through them all and really hate her life, but also because I just feel like if we have more, we'll have just more videos to react to, and I am so about that. So that said, guys, I'm going to go rest my back right now because I am in tremendous pain. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you next time, and fair winds.